saw our next guest on season 10 of MasterChef, and today he's here with a four-berry cheesecake trifle from his cookbook, New Keto Cooking. As you can tell, I'm pretty excited. Please welcome Chef Michael Silverstein.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you, man. Great to be here. Let me start by saying you look amazing, man.
Thank you.
You really do. You've had a real transformation. Obviously going low carb, getting into the keto world here. Tell us a bit about why you wanted to make this transformation. What was it about this diet that made you want to start eating differently?
Yeah, look, you know, I love cooking. I'm in the kitchen all the time. I'm eating, I'm cooking every day, and I lost control. You know, I got to my 30s, I was scared to step on the scale, and when I did, I was not happy. I was over 300 pounds. I knew something had to change. The thing is, I love cooking so much, so I had to find a diet where I could do that, eat all the good stuff, you know, eat real food, not diet food. And I hate that term diet, you know?
Beautiful.
And that's really where I found keto, because you can eat delicious food all the time, you know, and kind of have your cake and eat it too, so to speak.
I mean, it's so true. And you talk about looking better, but I know you also feel so much better, which is a big plus for the keto diet, low-carb diet. Okay, let's get into this. Just look at all these yummy berries, everybody.
Yeah,
that's where
beautiful
we're
berries.
Start. You got a mixture of all these great berries.
Yeah, and you know, you hear a lot of stuff about keto that you can't have fruit, you can't, but you know what, it's not true. You can have delicious whole foods, meat, vegetables, and some berries like this are totally fine. And what I love about this dessert is it's so simple to make, no bake, no gluten, no flour. I mean, this is the easiest dessert you could possibly make in your life, and it makes an impression on the table when it's done, and you'll see how
Absolutely.
It comes together.
So you're cooking these berries down a little bit, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So I'm just gonna really simply cook these berries down right here in the pan. And you know what's really nice about this as a little trick is that you can make your own fruit jams at home. All you need is a little bit of sweetener and fruit, and you just cook it down for 20 minutes, and you have your own homemade fruit jam.
I love it. Now, what sweetener are you using here? Because this, obviously we're trying to look for low carbohydrate.
You know, this is allulose, and what I love about allulose, it's a new sweetener on the market. It doesn't have that diety taste, and so I really like it. And as a chef, it kind of performs the way sugar does.
Okay, beautiful.
So
helpful to know. So how long does that take to kind of cook down and mix together?
Oh, just about 10 minutes. If you were going to turn it into a full jelly, you'd double that into 20.
You know what I just realized? I'm sitting here with the dessert in front of me and I haven't started.
Yeah, dive in before I do.
Shocking for me. All right, good. So you cook that down, but then you want to make sure it's chilled before
you add
it.
That's right, that's right. That's why we have some here that we already threw in the freezer just for a few minutes, because if you added the hot berries to your cream cheese, you're gonna melt everything, and that's not what you want. You like it?
This is amazing. And by the way, everybody, I know we're talking about low carb and keto and all that stuff, but this is something that everybody can enjoy as a dessert that's not gonna cause a spike in your blood sugar. It's not gonna cause a lot of inflammation afterwards.
That's right.
Just enjoy it, regardless of how you eat, right?
Exactly.
Okay, so you got that in the blender with some cream cheese.
And all we did was whip up that cream cheese so it's light and fluffy, and that's really all we want, because we're building kind of a no-bake cheesecake base with these berries that were cooked down. And within just a couple of seconds, you have the easiest kind of no-bake berry cheesecake mousse, I guess you could say. And you see that beautiful color already forming, and that, you know, even on your cup, you can see that beautiful,
rich purple color.
So
you bring that together.
Love.
I'm gonna help out a little bit and grab this guy.
Yeah, sure.
Mix that together.
And again,
and once that's kind of mixed together, you start building the layers, which we kind of got started here a little bit.
And this trifle is such a pretty dish for the holidays. It sits at the center of the table.
Wow.
What I also like about it is you can do it mini size as well and kind of make it romantic if you're doing date night or whatever, and do it either large or small, both work. But really simply here, we're going to start layering up our trifle.
Okay.
Super easy. Simple whipped cream, our cheesecake mousse, and then we just layer it in with more of these fresh berries. I love kind of putting them to the outside so you can see the pops of color.
And guys, berries, as far as fruit go, berries are pretty low sugar, especially strawberries, blackberries. So this is why sometimes on a lower carb diet.
They don't have the same effect on your glycemic index, so it's a little bit easier on your body to have berries as opposed to something like pineapple or mango, which is much more kind of rich in sugar.
I promise you, you guys will not notice that this is like a low-carb keto dessert. This is absolutely delicious.
You know what, I'm so glad to hear you say that, because that's literally everything I aim for as a chef, especially in keto. I just want food that anyone's gonna love.
I'm just trying to pace myself, that's all. Okay, so then you layer it up. I see you're putting in the berry cream cheese
mixture
now.
That's right, we go right on the top, and you know, you can take your time. You could do this with a piping bag if you really want it to be perfect, but you just bring in all these layers and it happens super quickly.
Beautiful.
Again, you don't have to bake anything. You don't have to do anything too complicated, which is just the recipes. that we need for the holidays. Now,
before you finish there, I want to make sure we come back to new Keto Cooking. Obviously, yeah. The book is going to be released next week. A lot of people very excited about this.
December 8th, everywhere, even international, December 8th, new Keto Cooking comes out. And this is the type of recipes you're going to find. Beautiful food that you can make at home that's kind of a little bit elevated, a little bit chefy, but still very accessible for anybody.
You top it with some berries and a little bit of mint on top, and it makes me very, very happy. And that one's for you, I guess. This one's for me.
Yeah, this one's all for me.
And it's really good to have you here in our house for the first time.
Thank you so much. Hey, I've looked up to you for a long time. My mom's a cancer survivor, and I really love what you do, and it really makes me happy to be here today.
That means a lot to me. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Thanks again. This is amazing, everybody. Michael's new book, New Keto Cooking, is available wherever books are sold, and you can get this great recipe at HallmarkChannel.com. Enjoy, everyone.
Thank you so much.